The debate on copyright, ladies and gentlemen, often involves extreme positions, rigid views, and emotive arguments. Having said that, just to talk for myself, it isn't a simple question, not at all. We need to recognize that it is a complex issue. Not to be dogmatic, but being very pragmatic, I think we could just follow the line. Not to consider the question as an abstract, philosophical issue, but to take it in the context and in the time. That should make sense. And let's remind ourselves of that context. The world we live in is changing fast, open door, but not unimportant to take that as a very important issue. Technology is changing. Business models, by the way, are also changing rapidly. And the way we consume and enjoy creative works, music, but also movies and also games, is changing that fast too. And if we want to keep the right balance, and who shouldn't want that, the legal framework has to respond. The last major EU copyright instrument, the Copyright Directive, was adopted in 2001, a long time ago. It is still in this century, but it is close to the last century, so to say. And the Commission proposals was based on date back to 1998. Talking about this sector, I think everybody is aware that it is old-fashioned, so to say. Let's remind ourselves what's happened since then. In 1998, and sometimes just one number is mentioning more than whatever, in 1998, Mark Zuckerberg was 14 years old. Today, almost 1 billion people around the world actively use Facebook to share videos, photos, IDs, and whatever. And in 1998, YouTube didn't exist. So today, 1 hour of video is uploaded every second. So can you imagine what's going on at this certain moment? And in 1998, most people listened to music on the radio, or CD, or tape. And now digital downloads often overtake conventional sales. New technologies allow downloading or streaming easily, instantly, wherever you are. Not just passively listen, but to interact and give feedback to creators and to friends. But changes are not limited to the content business. They affect all sectors. Huge changes have taken place in the research area. Fascinating what's going on there. Today, new scientific discoveries don't just come from new experiments, new drugs, new clinical trials. In fact, now we can get new results by manipulating existing data. Data and text mining techniques now lie behind a huge field of research like human genome projects, potentially life-saving, and they could hold the key to the next medical breakthrough, if only we freed them from their current legal tangle. Can you imagine what that could make for mankind? Research activities are not clearly exempted from the copyright rules, and there are many different rules in the 27 member states. And here is the most important change since 1998. Back then, creation and distribution were in the hands of few. Now, they are in the hands of everyone. Democratization, innovation, empowering people to generate and exchange ideas, supporting and stimulating huge creativity. And now, let's remind ourselves what are our objectives as policymakers should be for the creative sector. We should help artists live from their art, stimulate creativity and innovation, improve consumer choice, promote our cultural heritage, and help the sector drive economic growth. We can't look, ladies and gentlemen, at copyright in isolation. Please not. You have to look at how it fits into the real world. So let's ask ourselves, how well is the current system achieving those objectives in the world we live in today? That is a very real question, so to say, and a question that makes sense. Well, for one thing, you often find that online licensing restrictions make it impossible to buy music legally across an EU border. This morning, I spoke to the Italian digital industry, and they are facing big difficulties with the fact that in Europe, a consumer can't buy and rent a song or a movie or a missed TV program in another member state than Italy, for example. What is your answer to your citizens at such a moment? The guy was asking me. And I said, I would be in trouble. Video on demand and music should be open to citizens abroad as well in all EU countries. And they asked me why the audiovisual sector is more protected than any other sector where intellectual property law applies. We have already made a proposal on orphan works and recently one on collective right management to make multi-territorial licensing easier. The licensing proposal is a good step forward to make it easier to legally access the music you love, especially across borders. And I sincerely hope that legislators are able to agree it quickly. But this tackles only one aspect of the problem. Because there are other problems, too, beyond licensing or orphan works. And that is why the June Compact for Growth and Jobs makes clear we need to focus also on substantive copyright reform. And quite right, too. For example, I ask myself, are current copyright rules favorable to potentially life-saving scientific research? Or do they stand in its way? Do they make it easier or harder for people to upload and distribute their own new creative content? And is that the best way to boost creativity and innovation? How can we expect pan-European companies to succeed if, in practice, they have to deal with 27 different sets of rules, even if based on supposedly common European framework? How can we expect them to compete against American platforms that can easily market to hundreds of millions? If it took the BBC years of paperwork to market a TV program across the EU, how does that help repay their creative investment? How are those restrictions improving our economy? And how are they helping cultural diversity? And how are they helping artists to live from their art? And how are they helping stem piracy? In short, the world has changed and is changing still. The change is rapid, it is profound, and it is a huge opportunity for the creative sector. Each day we fail to respond, we are missing out. Consumers miss out on easy legal access to their favorite products. The creative sector misses out on new markets, new innovations, new opportunities. And we all miss out on new ways to share, to recognize, and appreciate our cultural heritage. And our economy overall misses out on the chance of new growth. Even today, ladies and gentlemen, we see the consequences of that loss. The initiatives we can't seize. The potentially high-flying ideas that got stuck on the runway. The glory and the benefits taken by American companies and not European. And every day that passes, we put ourselves in a yet worse position. And I'm afraid Europe can't afford that, not at this moment. And I'm glad to see that change is finally coming for copyright at many different levels. Internationally, the World Intellectual Property Organization is looking into a range of new copyright exemptions and limitations. Nationally, an increasing number of member states are recognizing the need for reforms and testing new ideas in this field. But we need a common European solution to avoid fragmentation and to seize benefits for a European digital single market. Now I'm glad the EU is playing its part too, so that our single market, our crown jewel, so to say, delivers for the creative sector. We have started a process to assess whether further changes are necessary. And for this, Michel Barnier and I myself, we are looking at whether and how the 2001 Copyright Directive needs to be adapted. And I fully back his commitment to do that, set out in the Commission's IPR strategy of last year. And during that process of assessment, we should leave passion aside and take a pragmatic view. Is our current system consistent and relevant within the real world? That is the question. And I'm open to ideas from all stakeholders, artists, consumers, businesses, researchers, and name it. Only together we can adapt ourselves to the future and stimulate innovation and growth. We know that the world is changing. We are aware that that change is fast. Let's not wait for ever faster technology to be ever more constrained by over more outdated legislation. Let's not wait for the US to speed ahead of Europe. Let's act right now for artists, for consumers, and for our economy. Thank you.